Hi friends, welcome back to React.js 0 to Hero series. This series is for beginners who wants to learn React.js from scratch. In the last video, I have explained about conditional rendering in React. In this video, I'm going to explain about component lifecycle methods. Let's start. Actually, I have already explained about useState hook, and I thought of explaining about the other hooks. But to understand useEffect hook, we need to understand about component lifecycle methods. And so in this video, let's see about component lifecycle methods. What are component lifecycle methods in React? Lifecycle methods are series of events that happen throughout the birth, growth, and death of a React component. There are three main categories of lifecycle methods: mounting, updating, and unmounting. A component mounts when it renders for the first time. This is when mounting lifecycle methods get called. And these methods are called in the following order: when an instance of a component is being created and inserted into the DOM, constructor, get derived state from props, render, and componentDidMount. The first time that a component instance renders, it does not update. Starting with the second render, a component updates every time that it renders. An update can be caused by changes to props or state. These methods are called in the following order when a component is being re-rendered: get derived state from props, shouldComponentUpdate, render, get snapshot before update, and componentDidUpdate. A component's unmounting period occurs when the component is removed from the DOM, and this method is called when a component is being removed from the DOM, componentWillUnmount. Among these, all the highlighted methods are the most commonly used lifecycle methods, and so let me explain all these methods using an example. I have created a new React application, in which I have created a class component. In this component, I just have a render method which returns a JSX element. The render method is the only required method in a class component. Other methods are optional. The render method should be pure always. That means render method should not modify component state. Let me put a console log. And so, if I refresh the page, we can see the render method is called. It is called twice because our app is in strict mode. Let me change that, otherwise it will confuse us. Now we can see it is called only once. Next, let's see about constructor. If we don't have any state or we don't want to bind any methods, we don't need a constructor. But even in that scenario, we can have a constructor. And if you have a constructor, first we need to call super. Otherwise, it will throw error. And if we need to have a state or we need to bind any methods, a constructor is needed. Even in that case, first we need to call super. If you are going to have any code before that, it won't work. The constructor for a React component is called before it is mounted. And so, if I have a console log, we can see it is called even before the render method. Typically, in React, constructors are only used for two purposes: for initializing local state and for binding event handlers. Let me create a state. And let me bind a method. We should not call setState inside a constructor. Instead, we need to assign it directly to this.state. Constructor is the only place where we should assign this.state directly. In all other methods, we need to use this.setState instead. Okay, next let's see about componentDidMount. componentDidMount is invoked immediately after a component is mounted. Let me have a console log here. And so we can see first the constructor is called, and then the render method is called, and finally the componentDidMount is called. If we need to load data from a remote endpoint, this is a good place to instantiate the network request. We can call setState inside componentDidMount, but this will trigger an extra rendering. Okay, let's see about componentDidUpdate. This method will be called for every re-render. This will not be called for initial render. And so, if I have a console log, we will not see it during the first render. Let me have a button and on clicking this button, let me call this function. In this function, we are updating the state and so this will trigger render again. Now let's see. If I refresh, we will not see component did update. But if I update, we can see the render is triggered again and component did update is called. And it will be called for every re-render even though the state is not changed. So we need to be little careful. We should avoid setting state inside component did update. In case we are going to set that, we need to make sure we are setting only if the previous state is different from the current state. Otherwise, it will lead to infinite re-render. This is also a good place to do network request, as long as we compare the current props to previous props, because a network request may not be necessary if the props have not changed. In case, if you are implementing shouldComponentUpdate also, then if it returns false, the componentDidUpdate will not be called. So if I have a console log, we can see shouldComponentUpdate is getting called. But as we are returning false, componentDidUpdate is not called. In case we are going to return true, we can see shouldComponentUpdate is called first and then the render method is called and finally componentDidUpdate is also called. So we can use shouldComponentUpdate to decide whether to trigger the render or not. And now let's see about componentWillUnmount. This method will be called just before the component is unmounted from the DOM. So this will be useful to do some cleanup activities. For example, if you need to clear the timeout or to cancel any network request or to unsubscribe any subscriptions, this is the right place. And we should not call setState in componentWillUnmount because the component will never be re-rendered. And to show you how componentWillUnmount works, let me create a child component. In which let me implement both componentDidMount and componentWillUnmount. In render method, let me return a simple JSX. So in this component, let me introduce a state and let me create two functions. One to set this state to true. And another one to set this to false. Let me bind these functions. Please note that if you are using normal function, we need to bind it. And if you are using arrow function, we don't want to bind it. Okay. And then let me have two more buttons. And let me call the respective methods. Finally, let me conditionally render this component based on the state. And so, if I refresh, we can see parent constructor is called, parent render method is called, and then parent component did mount is called. Let me clear this and let me click the show button. Now we can see should component update in parent is called, and then the parent render method is called, and then child render method is called, and then child component is mounted. And finally, parent component is updated. Let me clear this and click hide button. Now again, shouldComponentUpdate in parent is called and then parent render method is called. After that, child component is unmounted and finally parent component is updated. Hope you understood how these lifecycle methods are working. This will help you to understand use effect hook, which is coming next. For this concept, there is no task. That's all for today. Please like this video, subscribe to my channel and support me. Thank you. Bye.